Hi everyone, this is Daniel Kivitinos, co-founder of DrChrono. Today we have Luma Health. We're going to talk about how they built on DrChrono, how they integrated on the API, and what the company does.
My name is Aditya. I'm one of the co-founders of Luma Health, and I serve in the Chief Technical Officer, Head of Product role.
I'm Adnan Iqbal. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Luma Health. Awesome. And our third co-founder is the Shafin Akram. He's a physician, he's a practicing radiologist. So he's our chief medical officer, and he's today in clinic, so he's not able to join us today, but he is one of the original co-founders of the company.
Awesome. So you guys started the company when?
So we started a couple years back. Adnan and Tashfina started the company about a year and a half back when they were, had a couple ideas when they met at Stanford, and so we'll let Adnan give a little bit of that, and I came on a little bit later.
Yeah, so you know, Luma Health was literally an idea, I'd say, about 15, 16 months ago. Tashfina and I are actually college roommates. We both lived together for 2 years as undergrads at UC Berkeley. He went off to Michigan Medical School, trained there, practiced there, and was a full-time radiologist. Moved his family back to California last year to do his fellowship at Stanford Hospital, and that's where I was finishing up business school. And so we reconnected after many years, and really were literally sitting at Stanford Hospital's cafeteria and talking about different challenges and opportunities in the healthcare space. And one area that most resonated with us, and it was from our own experience, was that patients are waiting far too long for a first available appointment with their doctor.
So you guys got together roughly 16 months ago.
Yeah, so Tashina and I had the idea about 16 months ago. We were both finishing up our respective academic programs, and that's where we really wanted to test if this problem that we faced personally was something that was impacting the broader healthcare space. And so we ran a study with over 100 different healthcare providers, ranging from small independent solo practitioners all the way to the large complex healthcare systems like Kaiser and Sutter Health, and really everyone in between, academic medical centers, community hospitals, multi-specialty private practice groups, to test if this was something unique to us, if this was a problem broadly experienced by folks.
Got it.
Tashfina and I had hacked together the prototype. We're able to get an early pilot with the University of Maryland in their radiology practice, and got some great feedback there from just a learning perspective and a product perspective. We're fortunate to have Aditya join us full-time in February of 2015.
Awesome.
Tashfina and I are not product people. We had hacked together something that Aditya will not call a product. So Aditya, of course, has a tremendous product background. He led product at Microsoft, at Adobe, at Accenture, and most recently at Remind, which is an educational technology startup. So very relevant experience. Aditya and I have known each other for about 12 years, socially. Tashfina and I, of course, have known each other since college, which was 15 years ago, since we first lived together. But yeah, that's kind of how we all got together. And really, early this year is when the new version of the product, Aditya and team have built, and that's when we got really racing. And
one of the things that we did when we first started building the product was, we looked at the original prototype, I'll be generous in saying that Tashfina and Nana built, were like, what we want to do is we want to build a product from the ground up that enabled us to connect to the variety of EMR solutions that are available in the market. And what we want to do is build it to be flexible and give us very fast time to market when we had the ability to integrate with a industry-leading set of APIs. And so when we had the opportunity to work with DrChrono, one of the things that we saw was a very modern, very comprehensive, very restful Web 2.0 style API to access what is otherwise a very challenging access data set in an EMR. And so when we went to architect the product, we kind of followed a microservices architecture, and we used one of our microservices was an entire integration stack where we can very rapidly connect to different solutions such as DrChrono. And so when we started looking at DrChrono as a partner, what we ended up doing was we took a look at the API and we said, wow, actually, this actually looks very similar to our own internal data model, which is kind of interesting because, you know, there are, you know, 4 to 5 key actors in any, in office-based environment.
Right.
And so the models that we had on the DrChrono side and the Luma Health side were very similar. And so when we started to do an integration process, many of the kind of the web standard stuff that DrChrono exposed, such as like OAuth APIs, REST, bear tokens, all this sort of stuff, let us really then quickly run and get the first bits of data flowing into our system so that we're able for any provider who uses DrChrono to provide a really high fidelity experience because the quality of the API that DrChrono provided and being able to integrate with a kind of very comprehensive and very familiar looking data model that we have in Luma Health. So it's probably helpful to explain what Luma Health is and what we do. So I'll let Adnan jump on that.
Yeah, so as I mentioned, the core problem was really from our own experience. I played soccer as an undergrad at Cal, tore my ACL my sophomore year, and I remember calling the Palo Alto Medical Foundation here in the Bay Area to get an appointment scheduled. And they told me it would be 3 weeks before I could get in to get an MRI done. Now, I was a student, so I had some free time during the day, and I really wanted to get back on the soccer field quickly. So I called the doctor's office every day, and day three, an appointment opened up, and I was able to drive down from Berkeley to Palo Alto and get seen, and was on my path to healing in days, rather than waiting 3 weeks just to get the process started. And in a similar vein, Tashfeen would experience a similar problem at his practice in Michigan, where he would leave his clinic in the evening, come back in the morning expecting a full patient load. And every day when he would come in, there'd be four or five or six empty slots in his calendar every single day. And at first he thought, hey, this is great, it allows me to catch up on some of the other work that I need to do. But the more he thought about it, he knew he had patients waiting 3, 4, sometimes up to 5 weeks waiting to see him. And he's fairly business savvy, and he thought, this doesn't really make any sense. My patients are waiting a long time to get to see me, even though I have open appointments available every day. And I'm on the hook in terms of costs for my front office scheduling staff, my trained MRI technician, and the big capital equipment that I have, the big MRI machines, whether I do 5 studies or 50 studies in a day. So something's not right. And so that's really the problem we identified in running that survey with over 100 different healthcare providers. And we found that patients are waiting in the US anywhere between 2.5 up to 12 weeks for a first available appointment with their doctor, especially a specialist doctor. And the same doctors at their clinic, at their office, at their hospital are experiencing anywhere between a 15 up to a 40% short notice cancellation rate. Right?
Wow.
So every day you have patients waiting for and needing an appointment, and every day you have open appointments available. But
right.
That's where the gap exists, where there's no good way to match patients to open appointments.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where Luma Health comes in. Right? We help healthcare providers match patients to open appointments. Today it's a very human, deep time-consuming process. Someone gets on the phone and starts calling patients, crossing them off a list.
Right.
Luma Health completely automates that entire process. It's web-based for the staff members who are using it. It's a mobile-based experience for the patients who are interacting with the provider. And we're able to fill appointments for a healthcare provider within minutes. Right. And the goal for us is to really to own the communication platform with the patient from that very first appointment reminder, make it easy for a patient to confirm or cancel an appointment, then automatically help that patient reschedule that appointment that you cancel.
Right.
Help a healthcare provider generate a smart wait list, process that wait list real time, and fill any open appointments. And so it takes a staff member roughly 20 calls to fill one appointment. We're able to fill a single appointment within minutes of real time. And then following the appointment, we like to maintain communication with the patient in terms of driving follow-up care, medication reminders, medication compliance, exercise regimens, diet control, etc., depending on what type of care setting it is and what type of appointment and diagnosis the patient has.
So say I'm a patient.
Yeah.
And I call my dermatologist.
Yeah.
Sometimes the wait is months.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So
2 to 3 months on average in the US.
What would be the experience for the patient? So they call their, someone calls to cancel.
Right.
And I'm on a waiting list. The doctor puts me out and like books me for 2 months
That's
out.
Right. Yep.
Says, well, I will also put you on the waiting list. So I'm on the waiting list from Luma Health.
That's right.
Right.
What happens for me as the patient?
So if you're the waiting patient, let's say someone cancels for tomorrow at 2 p.m. So on Friday at 2 p.m., someone cancels for that appointment slot and it's for, your derm. What'll end up happening is you as a patient, as the waiting patient, will receive a text message.
Okay.
The message will say, hey, good news. You have an appointment has opened up with Dr. Johnson. It's at Friday at 2 p.m. If you'd like to claim this appointment, reply yes. You have 15 minutes to reply.
Cool.
And so what we do is two things that are actually really interesting there. Number one is we provide a text, which is very actionable right there from the message.
Yeah.
There's no pick up the phone. It's in situ for the patient. And number two is we put a time cap on it. And so that we actually try to force a little bit of action on the patient's behalf and to give the doctors an opportunity to offer that same slot to other patients if someone was non-responsive, they were unavailable, whatever it might be.
Yeah.
And so the patient replies yes, and then the provider gets a notification, depending on the provider, or it gets directly booked in their EMR and the patient gets a confirmation. It says, great, your appointment with Dr. Johnson is confirmed for tomorrow at 2 p.m. So it's pretty, from the patient's experience, it's very, very seamless. It looks like basically one text they reply to, and then the process is complete. And then from the provider's perspective, once they cancel out an appointment from the EMR or someone calls in, they say, go to Dr. Crown and say, this appointment's canceled.
Yeah.
The whole process is automated from them on that side.
Okay.
And then someone fills in that spot automatically, or if they don't want us to write directly into their EMR, we can send them an email, a notification that says, hey, someone's available this time. Would you like to book them?
Mm-hmm.
So we give the practice the flexibility and the patient the real quick ease of use, like in situ, in text message ability to book their appointment.
To date, I think we have over almost 800,000 appointments per month going into DrChrono.
Mm-hmm.
Close to 20 million in total appointments booked. So there's a lot of, I'm sure, canceled appointments.
Absolutely, yeah.
That would well be filled. I'm sure the doctors would be happy because they're running these practices and they come in and half the appointments may be there, they may have been canceled. So it's really the staff member who are going to save the time.
Yeah, there's three key benefits, right? Yeah. First and foremost, this helps healthcare providers keep their schedule full, right? Which means they're making more money, making more revenue.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Secondly, we're improving staff productivity. Staff today spend anywhere between 2 to 6 hours on this very manual, tedious work to call patients, chase them down, remind them, reschedule them, fill cancellations.
Right.
As if they can even carve out that time during the day, right? So you can reallocate that staff to doing much more value-added work, which, you know, can be billing, it could be prior authorization, working with insurance companies, ensuring patients get seen, right? And I think thirdly, and most importantly, we help patients get seen sooner.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Today, patients are waiting 3, 4, many months sometimes for an appointment. It's way out in the future. This gives them an opportunity to get seen within days or, you know, far sooner than they're actually scheduled. And so that's incredibly important, one, from a health outcomes perspective. Patients who get seen sooner have a better health outcome. And secondly, just from a patient experience perspective, right?
Yeah.
We're removing all the pain, friction that exists today for a patient to have to manage, reschedule, rebook, cancel an appointment.
Right.
All that's happening over a simple text, and you're getting soon. You're getting seen with the provider you want, when you want, and quickly.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So one last thing, how long did it take you guys to build on the API?
So we started the process from start to finish. It was maybe about a week and a half to 2 weeks.
Okay.
It was actually a really straightforward process. Like I was saying earlier, the data model was very recognizable to us. The APIs followed a lot of standard web conventions. So we were able to get up and running real fast. We took advantage of the DrChrono Google group to ask a couple questions on the API. So, and found the team to be really responsive. So it, to start to finish is about 2 weeks. And then, you know, it's kind of now working with customers to figure out, you know, how to actually best optimize and implement and use the product in the field. So it was actually a really straightforward experience that you'd expect from using kind of any web-based application.
Well, thank you guys for being here. And
thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thanks.